Welcome to ArtStarts Explores, our province of play. Are you ready to get creative with us this week? Let's review our three basic rules that guide us through our exploration and play. Rule one is respect. We want to respect ourselves, anyone we're making with, our tools and making space, and the lands and waterways where we're making. How can you practice respect when you explore, play, and make? Rule two is no expectations. If we're not expecting something to turn out good or bad, we're open to it going in a whole bunch of different ways. And that means that all respectful, creative explorations are great, regardless of what it ends up looking like. Try to do things you've never tried before and ask yourself, what will happen if I... Rule number three is nothing is for keeps. Everything we make together is a test, or a draft, or creative playtime. We're just trying things out. What can you make or try today and then take apart or recycle? What can we learn by making and not keeping? These are our three rules for when we explore together every week. Okay, what will we explore together this week?
So today I am super excited to take you on an adventure. Today we're going to do a nature adventure. We're going to be finding objects in nature to do an art project. I hope you are as excited as I am. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Rocio Graham and I'm a botanical artist. That means that I like to work with things that I find in nature to create pieces of art. So today I'm going to be teaching you or sharing how we can make together a mask. And you might be wondering why masks are so important. I think masks allow us to express ourselves. We can use it for fun. We can use it for ceremonial practices. We can use it to pretend that we are somebody else. I come from Mexico. And in Mexico, we use a lot of masks for dances and for festivals. We use it for celebrations. We use it also to express ourselves. And I wanted to show you how I did this papier-mâché mask using maps. But this might be a little bit, you know, a little bit complex to do. So I wanted to show you how, in many cases, I use nature to create art. In this case, I use flowers and pine cones to make a mask, and I'm super excited to show you how you can do that with objects that you can find in nature, but also things that you can find in your recycling bin. Now, I'm going to be giving you some examples of how we can work with nature to create a mask that actually speak about our connection to a place. But at the end of the day, please break all the rules. Use your imagination. Create something different. It doesn't have to look like what I'm showing you today. So please, are you ready for this adventure? I hope you are, because I'm sure I am super excited. So as I was mentioning, it's very important that in this adventure that we're gonna do in nature, we start to think about how we connect to the land, what it makes us a place so special. And the mask that we're gonna be creating is a representation of that care or that love or that excitement that we feel about a space. In this particular place, I love this park. I come here often and play with my children. So for me, this is a really, really fun park, and I hope you have your favorite park as well. So what we're going to do is that we're going to go on a walk and we're going to try to collect as many different variety of objects or pieces of nature that we find, organic materials. So for example, I don't know, like I love different things like, you know, pine cones and, you know, dry leaves that they're so beautiful. Let's see what else we can find. I don't know if I'm gonna use this, but I'm gonna take it anyway. And at the end, the good thing is that I can actually bring it back to the park and return whatever I didn't use, or return the piece that I finished. So this is what we're gonna do today. So let's get to it. Oh, look at this. I think this will be amazing for our mask. Don't you think? I think it's really, really, really good. Oh, okay. Now, this is a score. You have to agree with me. This is really, really beautiful. Oh, look at this beautiful seeds, more pine cones. What else? What else should I find here? I don't know. Oh, there's a... You know what? Ask an adult if there is a plant that you want to take, because an adult can tell you if that plant is something that is safe for you or is something that maybe we should leave there. So we're going to try to pick things that they're not living. Let's try to find things that are, you know, like leaves that they already discarded, that they already, you know, that nature is giving it to us. And this is going to be so exciting because every time I wear this mask, it's gonna remind me of the beautiful memories that I have with this space. So this space is very, very special. And I hope that you go on your adventure in your favorite place. Look, you know, I found pieces of moss. And look at this, this is a score. Again, you know, I try to pick things that they are already on the ground. I'm not picking live plants, you know, because we want to protect our environment. And I'm just looking at things that there are lots of abundance of, like, you know, pine cones and leaves and bark, whatever you find, wherever you are, I can't wait to see what you create, because I'm pretty sure it's gonna be very unique, just like you. Are you ready to go into this exploration together? Okay, well, let's get to the studio. So now what we're gonna do is the papier-mâché paste, which is pretty much a homemade glue. And for that, we need 1 cup of flour, and we need 2 teaspoons of apple cider or any vinegar, really. And so what we do is that we boil 4 cups of water. And once they are boiled, we need to be very careful. This is something that you need to do with an adult because we don't want to get hurt. So what we're going to do, we're going to boil the water. And once it's boiling, we are going to add the flour that I already diluted in 1 cup of cold water. So what we are going to do is put it in the hot water, and it's going to start thickening. And we are going to mix it, making sure that we stir it very well so it doesn't get with clumps or grumos, how do we say it in Mexico? I used to do this with my grandmother to make calaveras or Dia de los Muertos flowers, and also for making piñatas. So I grew up making this as a glue. Alternatively, you can use glue at home, like just liquid white glue, if you do not want to make this paste for the papier mache, but I really, really like the consistency. So why we add, okay, so it's boiling now, and I think it's thickened. So I'm gonna lower the heat. Be careful because you don't wanna burn yourself. And I think it's pretty much done. Now I'm gonna add a little bit of vinegar, and the vinegar, as I said, is like 2 teaspoons, but the reality is like, I don't like to measure. I just add something to it. So, okay, we have it here, oops. There we go, and then we continue mixing. Vinegar helps so it doesn't get moldy. You can also add salt. And this will make the engrudo, or the homemade glue, ready for our papier-mâché mask. Perfect. So we got it. Today we're gonna work on a concept of a mask, and I have a little diagram or a little drawing that I did about something that we can work together. These are things that I found in the recycling bin. I wanted to show you, you know, I found this paper, that it was there, and I even found this paper in the recycling bin that I thought that we could use. So in terms of what we're gonna use, you go to the recycling bin and try to find some paper that you can use. Ideally, you can find some newspapers or magazines. I actually had a very old map too that I'm gonna try to use today. And I found some other materials. I have no idea where this adventure is gonna take me, but I'm excited about it. I got some acrylic paint as well, and a brush, and then I also have a gun, of a hot gun. You're gonna need help with from an adult perhaps to help you use this. You don't want to get burned. We are going to use the papier-mâché glue that I you know, that I showed you how to do earlier. I found some paper here too that I thought that we could use for this mask, maybe to create a beak or something, I don't know. But I'm super excited because this is a botanical mask. So again, you know, why are we doing a mask, you wonder? And what is the connection between a mask and a map? You know, we use a map to represent or to map out a place. So, you know, why are we doing? We're doing it because it's fun. We're doing it because in my perspective, allows me to connect to a space and allows me to create a memory of a geographical place. You know, it's a story. So in this case, the mask that I'm gonna create today is gonna tell a story of a geographical area, because these materials that I found are from a park that I really, really, really like. So this mask is telling a story about the land. So I'm very, very excited about creating this with you today. And I even found some seed pods and acorns, there's rocks. And anyway, so the idea is that we use our imagination, our creativity, to see what can we use at home, and something that we can just return back to the land when we're done. Okay, so now what I'm going to do, I'm going to do the base for the mask. And to do that, I use a piece of paper that I found in the recycling bin, and I drew, I started by drawing a line in the middle using a ruler. Then I ended up doing another one here, so into a cross. And then from there, this is just, you know, again, we're exploring, so it doesn't have to be exact, but if you want to measure, you could. So the idea is that from the center,
to the next line, which is the center of the eye, will be 1 1/4 inches. 1 1/4 inches, and that will be the center of the eye here. And then I had another line here that is another 2 inches here and 2 inches here. So that gave me the edge of the mask. And from here to here, if you're into measurements, is 1.1 1/4 inch from the what is going to be the nose tip. And then from here to here is 4 inches. And then I try to just loosely find a way, you know, just to draw a curve, to just imagine it. This is my forehead. This is going to be my eyes. You know, it doesn't have to be exact. So now what we're going to do once I did this drawing, and again, you can just like, honestly, you can just wing it. Or you can be exact. And as I said, these are the dimensions. So we are now, we are going to cut the shape of the mask. This is going to be our structure. So, okay, again, I used paper, cardboard that I had in the recycling bin. And now I have to fold this to cut the eyes. They don't have to be perfect. This is about having fun and learning something, right? And see what works and what doesn't work, right? And we always have to ask questions like, you know, what if, you know, instead of drawing it like that, I do it like shorter and I do an arc? What if I don't do it as long? Or maybe you want to add some extra space here in the forehead. What if? So it's a lot of what ifs questions, right? So now I have the base or the beginning of the mask. So there you go. So now we are going to continue doing our project. So I found a lot of paper, as I mentioned it to you, and I'm going to use the paper from the newspaper that I found in the recycling bin. So what I'm going to do is starting to do what I call it a churrito, or a little twist. I just had this idea that maybe I can weave this into the mask and maybe that would look really cool. I don't know. I don't really know how it's gonna look. As I mentioned before, I work very intuitively. That means that I have a loose idea about what I wanna create, but at the ending of the day, I just play. I want to discover something new. So what are we going to do with these churritos or little twist? I'm going to twist the paper as I did it here. And then I'm covering it with masking tape. To just give it a structure. You see? So I got one churro and I got another churro. And another churro. So I have 1, 2, 3 churros, 3 churros. Yay! So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe these ones, they can be interwoven. Como una trenza. And as I said, I had an idea at the beginning, but then my hands have another idea, so I have to let them guide me. And I'm going to start using the engrudo, or the paste that we did for papel mache, again, which is just boiling water with flour in a nutshell, to start covering it, because I have a map and I think it would be a really good idea to cover these churros or these tubes into with some maps, because this is about a perfect place that I love, which is a park that is in Christina Lake and is one of my favorite parks, and I happen to have a map about that. Okay, as I mentioned, I found some maps that I'm going to be cutting. Maybe, you know, someone in your family has a map that wants to give you that you can use. I don't know, it's amazing what you can find in the recycling bin. If you don't have a map, you don't have to. Let's try to find what other things, what other materials can we use instead of maps? And instead of paper, maybe we're gonna use, botanicals. So now what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be using the Engrudo 2B, wrapping my churros, these little paper tubes, or serpents, they look like little snakes, and I'm going to cover them in Engrudo. And I learned to make Engrudo from my abuela, my grandma in Mexico. We used to make Engrudo all the time when we were making paper flowers for the Day of the Dead celebrations that we had in November. So that's how I learned to make Engrudo. We go one churro, and I was thinking about adding this crumble paper to give it some texture to this mask, and I think I think it's gonna look really, really, really good. And now the mask is all dry, we finished adding all the map. And now I want to think about what elements of the objects that I collected, the botanical materials that I collected from the park, can tell the story of the place or will help me with a memory. So I really like this moss and I want to use it, but I don't know exactly where, but this is fantastic. So I think I'm going to start with this. I'm going to use the glue gun. Again, you can use glue. If you don't have a glue gun, you have to use whatever we have. And I'm gonna poke a little hole in here. So maybe I can try to add this piece in here. And I'm going to glue it there. Because this is a big object, and it's hot, we have to be very careful here. And I'm going to just add these needles here and glue them. Have to be very careful. But you know what? Maybe instead of that, we can use glue to add the needles. We can definitely do that. Why don't we do that? I think that's probably a better idea because I do not want you to get burned, but I really like this. I'm using two types of glues. One is the Engrudo or the papier mache glue that we created. But I know usually I like to work with a glue gun because I can work faster, but I understand that this is not exactly for everyone, so that's okay. We can use just papier mache paste, and that's okay, or glue, or even tape. We have to think about what happens if I use this material instead of this other material. So it's about, you know, exploring our creativity and, you know, so I'm just giving you an example of how you can use different materials to create, to tell the story of a place. So you see, it's gluing quite nicely. So it doesn't matter. You can use Engrudo or you can use Engrudo, the papier mache paste, or we can use the glue gun. As I mentioned, I really like to work with the glue gun, but I understand that perhaps you don't have one at home, and that's okay. If that's the case, then let's try to use something else You know, leaves are definitely easier to glue with just regular white glue. As I explained it earlier, what I'm trying to do here is tell the story of a place. I'm creating memory, and all these little pieces, they're helping me tell that story of that beautiful park that we just visited. So maps allow us to find a way to understand a space, you know, like what animals live there, what kind of plants live there. And, you know, I think for me, allows me to have a connection to the land and allows me to have more respect for a space. So for me, look at this. I found this in the garden too. There you go. Oh, it has all the seeds. Fun. So I think it would be really, really nice if we add them here. What do you think? If I decided to use just engrudo or the homemade glue, it will glue, but it's just gonna take a little bit longer. And that's okay, because we are working with what we got. And I feel pretty happy about this piece because I'm using botanicals. So I know that when I am done here, I can go back and maybe leave it in the park and someone else can enjoy my creation. What do you think? Have you thought about maybe you do the same thing? You make a mask that honors the space, then we go to the park and then we leave it there for others to enjoy. What do you think? Doesn't really matter what kind of glue you use for this. Again, this will take longer. That's okay. Now, I really want to use these structures, which are quite heavy. So I'm going to have to use the glue gun. Otherwise, they're not going to be able to get attached. And I'm just going to put some pressure. You can ask an adult or someone to help you if this is a little bit difficult for you, or if it's too hot, you don't want to burn. We have to be super careful. We have to be very, very, very safe. Okay, so we are just going to gently press for the mask to really attach. Okay, so our glue is almost dry. Uh-oh, I have to be careful. So you see, I just glue this churro, and now I have to think about what I want to do with the next one. I actually twisted this one, and I think it would be really cool to add it here. You know, it will be probably hard to see, but it doesn't matter because at the end of the day, remember that I said I was going to return this mask to the park. So I am going to use a little bit more glue. I'm gonna bring some glue here, the center of the nose to hold it. And more here. So we have this spiral of this little churro. You see, I had no idea what this mask was going to look. And I hope that you had no idea neither what your mask is going to look though, because that is part of the exploration. If we have a very, very strong idea of how we want our art to look, then we get disappointed when things don't work out the way that we imagine. And I'm more interested in learning about how to use the material. I learned so much about needles, pine needles. I learned a lot about these little pine cones, these little poppy seeds. And I know now which objects are lighter or heavier and which ones they got together. I love these colors. Again, so we were just doing an exploration. So we have another one. I did three, and I should only have done two. Now, this is a perfect example when you plan and then you realize that this is not gonna work. So I'm okay to discard this churro or this paper tube, papier mache tube that I did. Because I don't know. I don't know. What do you think? I think we should definitely let it go. And I'm okay with that. We are almost finished here. I loved this leaves that I found. They are so beautiful, and I think they will look really nice like that. Look at that. It looks like a ribbon. This is why I love working with nature, because I always get surprised and I discover new things about a place. And by having a mask of that place, I feel that I'm connecting to that place, that geographical area better. And I feel like almost like I'm wearing the place that I love so much. So we have... I think that's it. This was my process. I just did it with you. Thank you for giving me company today and for taking me on this adventure to learn more about a place and how maps can help us connect to a place and to learn more about a place, because they show us, is a representation of a place, you know, what kind of animals they live there, what kind of roads they live there. You see this one? Now, the next part is to do the cleanup. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I can't wait to see what you created. Please send me pictures. I want to see what you created yourself, and what stories are you telling of a place? What is your connection to the land? How are you connecting to a space? Lots of gratitude. We did it! This is what the mask looks like after it's finished. And now it's time for me to take it back to the recycling bin, or I'm thinking about maybe taking it to the park so other people can actually enjoy it as well. I hope you had as much fun as I did. Thank you so much for joining me today.